better place. We have 40 days to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. By the help of God, to make our world a better place.
Students, I'm hoping that you're fine. I welcome you to today's lesson. I want us to look at the roles of the Holy Spirit. This is a Form 3 work. We want to see how the Holy Spirit works. We want to see the teachings of the Holy Spirit. Remember, the Holy Spirit is the third party in the Trinity. The Holy Spirit is what the person The Holy Spirit is a person. It is a person that replaced Jesus. After Jesus died, resurrected, and gone to heaven, the Holy Spirit has been sent by God the Father to replace him. And I will look at the Holy Spirit. We look at the roles of the Holy Spirit. I will look at Paul's teaching on the gifts of the Holy Spirit. What is the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit is the third person in the Trinity. Trinity is God the Father, God the Son, and now God the Holy Spirit being the third person. Let us look at the roles of the Holy Spirit. What does the Holy Spirit serve to the believers? What does the Holy Spirit, what role does the Holy Spirit play to the believers? The role number one is that the Holy Spirit of God lives in the hearts of the believers. Once is a believer, you believe in Jesus Christ, it is said that the Holy Spirit of God dwells in you. Why? Because he has come to replace Jesus Christ in your life. So the Holy Spirit lives in the hearts of a Christian. That is his role number one. Spirit. He will act as an advocate, a counselor, a comforter to those ones who love Jesus and obey his commandment. Once one loves Jesus and obeys the commandment, the Holy Spirit acts as a counselor, a comforter. Becomes an advocate, speaks on your behalf, comforter, counselor, advocate for them who believes in Jesus Christ. Another reason is the Holy Spirit continues the work of Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit continues the work of Jesus Christ. It is the person that replaced Jesus. Now, he continues the work of Jesus Christ. Another thing, the role of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will reveal the truth about God. Reveal the truth about God. Remember, now it is the Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Now it is God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit tells us what it is in the mind of God. Now it will reveal to the Christian that what is in the mind of God. That is the role of the Holy Spirit. He will remind the disciples, the followers of Christ, the message of Jesus. Remind the disciples the message of Jesus. Jesus taught. What Jesus taught, now Jesus is not there. The Holy Spirit will be speaking to the disciples, to the followers of Jesus, what exactly was spoken by Jesus. Remind the disciples the message of Jesus. The Holy Spirit will encourage the disciples, will encourage the disciples in face of persecution. Encourage the disciples in case of, or in the face of persecution. It will give the Holy Spirit. Remember, the Holy Spirit is a person. We are referring to him as he. So he will give the disciples the power to become the witness of Christ. They will witness Christ. They will indeed walk in their steps boldly, saying that Jesus is the Messiah. He died, he is risen, he is living at the right hand side of the Father. Another thing, the Holy Spirit will interpret the message of Jesus to the disciples. He will interpret the message of Jesus to the disciples. Speak to them the message of Jesus with clarity and understanding to the disciples. Now, the Holy Spirit again will reveal the mysteries about God. They will know the mysteries about God. They will know everything about God. Another thing about the Holy Spirit, he will get to know. The disciples will be able to understand the hidden and the secret sins of the people. The disciples will understand the secret sins. The Holy Spirit will be able to open up the minds of people, the hearts of people, so that the disciple will do what? Will be able to understand. Another thing, the Holy Spirit, the roles of the Holy Spirit will help the disciples or the followers to understand what is right and what is wrong. What is right and what is wrong. And now with this, that these are some of the roles of the Holy Spirit. What does the Holy Spirit help a believer? What are the roles of the Holy Spirit? I want us to go to the Paul's teaching on the gifts of the Holy Spirit. What are the gifts of the Holy Spirit? These are the extraordinary favors that are granted to Christians so that they can perform the extraordinary. The extraordinary favors that are given to Christians so that they can perform extraordinary, so they can perform the ministry of Jesus. The number one gift of the Holy Spirit, we have the gift of speaking in tongues. This refers to the speaking through a language that other people around you or other believers are not able to understand. It is rare for all the believers to understand. And the speaking in tongues is for self-edification. Remember, the gifts of the Holy Spirit are meant to edify or to bring glory to God and not to the person. So speaking in tongues is speaking in a different language that other people are not able to do what? To understand. Interpretation of tongues. Interpretation of tongues is the ability or that gift that you are able to identify or to understand the different language or the unique language that someone else is speaking, which is called the tongue. You are able to understand that language and give its interpretation or explanation to other people. Remember, the gift of speaking in tongues was poured to the disciples immediately after Jesus had left. There is another gift of prophecy. Prophecy is the gift to predict about the future. You are predict about things that will happen in future. The gift of miracles, of working miracles. The gift of working miracles is the gift in which a believer is able to work signs and wonders. Another gift, it is a gift of healing. The gift of healing is the gift to heal all the diseases using the name Jesus Christ. We have other gift of faith, the gift of love, the gift of preaching, and so forth. With that, I thank you for being my student. Have a good day.